In the last episode of the series, we learned about the fundamental concept of Go, the life and death of stones. In this episode, we will learn about the Ko rule, an important rule that ensures the game runs smoothly, but also could determine the life and death of a group of stones. So let's dive right in. What is the Ko rule? Well, the Ko rule states that a play cannot be made if it immediately recreates the previous position of the game. What does that mean? Well, it's best illustrated by an example. So, let's take a look at this situation here. This black stone in the middle is not connected to any of the nearby stones, and it only has one liberty left. White can therefore capture this black stone by placing a white stone at this point. This is where the Ko rule comes into play. If black decides to immediately play a black stone to recapture this white stone, then we see that the board is reverted to its original position. White would then recapture this black stone as well, and then this would result in an endless loop. To prevent this from happening, the Ko rule does not allow the player to recapture a stone immediately after it has been captured the turn before. Instead, black has to play elsewhere on the board. This gives white a chance to connect if they so choose, or to continue playing elsewhere. So if black plays here, and white decides to play here, then black can therefore recapture this white stone. A common type of play in response to the Ko rule is known as the Ko threat. By playing a Ko threat, a player forces the other to respond, giving them a chance to recapture a stone. So, let's return to this situation. We saw that white placed a stone here to capture the black stone. In response, black can play here on the left and threaten to capture this white stone in the next play, which now only has one liberty left. So, if white decides to connect this white stone, black can now capture this white stone in the next turn. Therefore, white would naturally want to connect this white stone, allowing black to have a chance to recapture this white stone. Now, before we move on, it is important to note that the Ko rule only applies to specific situations. Let's take a look at this group of stones. These two stones have only one liberty left, which allows white to capture them by placing a stone here. However, this white stone now also only has one liberty left, and black is indeed allowed to play here to recapture this white stone because this does not revert the board to its original position. So, what makes the Ko rule so important? Well, sometimes it can determine the life and death of a group of stones. So, let's take a look at this group over here. This group of white stones seems to have two real eyes and one false eye. However, if black captures this white stone, this eye now has become a false eye. If black eventually reconnects this black stone, then this white group is dead. So to prevent this, white has to recapture this black stone and connects its stones together to ensure the safety of this real eye and thus the safety of this entire group. But as the Ko rule states, white cannot immediately recapture this black stone, and so it has to find a Ko threat. So where can white find a Ko threat? Well, this group of black stones over here only has two liberties. If white plays a stone here, then this group of 20 black stones can be captured in the next move if white decides to play here. So, to prevent that from happening, black will have to play here to reconnect its stones. Now that white and black have each played a turn, white can now return to this spot and recapture this black stone. Now, if black also has a Ko threat elsewhere, then this will allow black to eventually recapture this white stone as well, and this Ko fight could actually last a very long time. Sometimes, when the win or loss of a game comes down to one or two stones, a Ko fight is what determines the win or loss of the game. And that's it. The Ko-rule may be complex, but it is an essential rule to playing Go, allowing the game to proceed properly. In the next video, we will learn about scoring and how to determine the winner of a Go game. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment. Thank you for your support, and I'll see you next time.